What looks like a typical college dorm is actually a living laboratory for students at United Methodist-affiliated Duke University. Kelvin Gu gives tours. He says visitors to the 6,000-square-foot Duke Smart Home come to see the basement.
And the rainwater filters through the soil on the green roofs, and then it comes down here into these tanks. And pretty much all year round, we can take care of all of our toilet and washer needs with just rainwater.
The house has green features you would expect, like solar, electric, and water heating, and energy-efficient construction. It's also on the cutting edge of new technology.
The typical light will need a high-voltage wire to run to it. Because LEDs are so efficient, the amount of electricity coming through a cable that delivers your internet is enough to light a house. And so we have this capacity here so that in the future, when that technology is mature, we can take advantage of it. Also, we have great internet speed.
The exposed ductwork and encased wiring systems are designed to encourage engineering-minded students to tinker. Experiments range from serious to silly.
We can get temperatures of up to 170 degrees Fahrenheit. My roommate over the summer, he wanted to cook ramen noodles, and he just opened the tap in our bathroom. And I mean, it wasn't totally boiled, but we basically cooked ramen noodles with the water.
The house has 10 full-time residents, but about 50 students and faculty have taken an interest in projects here. Esther Granville stops by to do some weeding in her smart house garden plot.
I am a clinical research dietitian at Duke University, and I come and just work in the garden to try to grow some of my own vegetables.
The technology you see here may gradually be coming to your home.
People will be installing solar panels on their house as a matter of habit. I think the same way television sets got introduced into people's homes, there will be new utilities that will be introduced into people's homes.
This video was brought to you by the people of the United Methodist Church through World Service donations.